All right, now in this task, we have to indicate the fault of any inputs by red color indication on manual reset switch. How this can be done? Very interesting. First of all, I have to mention that here we have connected input 1 of this manual reset switch to IO2 of our SC controller. So if this input 1 is true, this will make the color red on the switch. Just like the last video, if input 3 is true, it will make it blue. If input 1 is true, it will make it red. Okay, so this, by combination of these three inputs, you can have different colors. So we have to remember our wiring when we do in our controller. So in our present case, input 1 is connected to IO2. So we have to use this IO2 as a feedback for any fault. How we can do that? Very simple. We turn off our live mode, go back to equipment, and from here we take another status, just like the last status for reset. We take another status, status outputs, and here you will find so many options. Track any input, track input fault, track any input fault, track input group, track outputs, output fault, all output faults, track output logical state, waiting for manual reset, which we already use, system lockout, or track functional block. So you have so many possibilities. We can use lots of the status outputs in our Ethernet and Profinet lectures as well. So you can use these to display on your HMI via Profinet or Modbus. Anyways, in our present case, we have to track any input fault. So click on this one, and this is your output. And remember where it is connected, IO2, which looks great. IO2 is this, PNP is on, and here I will rename that to fault. Okay. And this is connected. You don't have to do anything in the programming. This is just a status output. It will connect here. You can just confirm by going to your wiring diagram. So here you can see the wiring diagram of all the inputs. I04 is my manual reset switch. IN3 and IN4 for E-stop. IN5, IN6 with ISD for door switch. Magnetic switch to IN1 and IN2 with I01. And this is your outputs. And that's the power supply. So once everything looks okay, just download the configuration, save the project, put your password, and then continue. Outputs will be off. Ask the procedure, confirm what you did, and in the end, you just have to restart. So I will restart my controller, turn off, turn on again. Everything looks good. Now, just to make sure, if you don't get the signal, you can plug out your cable and plug in again, but at the moment it's fine. You go to live mode, and now you can see a live mode here and ISD here. So this is what I want to show you. Now, just to verify if everything is working fine as before, we have to reset it because you see a blue light, which is an indication. Now, LR blocks are reset, my outputs are true. Just to show you here in wiring diagram, R01, R02 is true. You can see the status of R01 on this relay, or you can see the LEDs there. Okay, now I told you we can detect the fault. So I cannot manually create fault in the sensors, but I can show you one example with this magnetic switch. If this is not connected properly, or if there is any deviation in this magnetic switch, this will show you a fault. And this fault you can see on the button. So let's try that. Now, in this state, you can see that this is deflected. And this is signifying a fault. And with that, you have seen that you have a fault signification here. Here you cannot see, this is for ISD, but if you go to functional view, you can see that this has a fault. Input 2.2 has a fault. Okay, you can maybe also see that here. Magnetic switch is not connected properly, and this fault is detected because IN1 and IN2 both are true. And if both of the signals are true, which means the sensor is not perfectly aligned. And that's the best way to determine the fault in the software. And using the software, you can also program if there is any of such fault, you can have a different LED color on your reset switch. So now you know immediately that you program this for any fault in the input. You will go check all the sensors, everything is okay. If not, just go there, realign your sensors, and now everything looks back, looks great, and the color changes to blue, super easy. Go there and reset. And now all the outputs are true again. This makes it super easy to troubleshoot your circuit by indicating faults on this LED buttons. This was the objective of this task, and I hope you like this task. And in the next video, we will see how we can interface SC10 controller with a PLC. And with a PLC, we're going to be using S7-1200, and we're going to use Profinet as a source of communication. So we're going to read non-safety inputs and outputs in the PLC and share the signals via Profinet. Thank you for watching, and if you like the video, put a comment. If you have any doubts, let me know. See you in the next video. Bye.